So I've been wanting to try this out for quite some time. I've been hearing a lot of tracks recently from an artist called Yamê. Big fan of his vocals and some of the haunting piano melodies that are on some of his beats. And I'm pretty sure he produces most of them himself as well, so it's very impressive. And honestly, on most of his tracks, I understand all the words he's saying because I speak French, but I have no clue what he's trying to say to me, bro. But regardless, in today's one, I'm going to be trying to make a beat in the style of Yamê. Okay, so I'm in FL Studio once again, but this might be one of the most ghetto setups I think I've ever had. Regardless, let's make a start. So the reference track I'm going to use for this one is one of my personal favorites. It's roughly 120, 125 BPM, so I'm going to set that right now. And has a very prominent piano melody, so I'm going to open up Keyscape real quick. And to me, the piano melody sounds like it's being manipulated. So I might just come up with a chord progression and try to chop it into something. I don't know, let's just see how it goes. I'm going to try and keep this one simple. Wait, I should probably pick a preset first. Oh. Okay, I forgot to mention that I lowered the velocities there at the end. That's why it sounds very different. I'm still not too happy with this result, so I think I am going to throw into a fruity slicer. So I'm going to open up Edison. I'm going to bounce out this melody. Some sort of hissing sound in the piano, so I'm gonna need some effects on that. I'm gonna throw an EQ on here, some Soothe 2 to get rid of the resonance. Very light love filter, it's basically not doing anything. And some shimmer. A few people told me to give this one a try, so. Because I took most of the low frequencies out, I think I'm just gonna keep the same melody, but half time it, put that just below that melody. I think I'm probably going to separate the beat into two parts. I think the first part of the beat is going to have a simpler melody, simpler drums. The second part of the beat is where I'm going to add a couple more things. So that took so long. I'm doing this 7 years almost, and it still takes me like 20 minutes to do a decent hi-hat pattern. Thank you. first part of the beat, that's completely fine. For the second part of the beat, I'm going to clone this pattern. I'm going to switch up the drums a little bit, probably use some different sound selection, and then I'll probably add some orchestral samples to try and fill in the gaps. First thing I'm going to change is I'm going to use the original piano melody that we started. I'm gonna do, I'm gonna clone the fruity slicer melody. I'm gonna put it up an octave, I think. I might chop it up a little bit though. I think I'm actually gonna throw in the halftime piano we had before, and I'm just gonna lower the volume a little bit to make room for other sounds. And as I mentioned earlier, before I add the drums, I'm gonna throw in a couple of orchestral samples in there. So I'm gonna go have a look around in Splice and see what I can find. I wonder if in the future there'll actually be a video where I just don't use Splice ever. Like, how am I gonna get a Splice sponsorship, bro? I use it in every video, like they don't have to pay me. Last thing I'm gonna add to this is I'm gonna look for some sort of like violin sample just to fill in the high frequencies, and then I think I'll leave it there, and then I'll continue the drum. Of course, it's time to make an All Might Tokyo Ghoul type beat. Sick of hearing this melody. I think at the very end it's gonna sound good, but I'm gonna take a break, come back, mix it, arrange it, and we'll see what it sounds like. So a couple changes I made. I reprogrammed the halftime piano, so now it fits the chords a little bit better, because there was too much dissonance in there for me, and especially in the second part of the beat, it didn't sound very nice. I added a pretty simple pad from Serum just to fill out the mid-range a little bit more. It just follows the chords and it sounds like this. In the 8-bar transition between the first and second part of the beat, I've added this re-space. And this bass preset is in the second Lovecraft sample library. Of course, I added the acapella for the reference track that I'm going for. I also made some changes to the second bass line. I added some 808 rolls in the second half because I found it kind of boring. I've already listened to this back a couple times. I think what kind of holds this beat back is just how repetitive it is. I still have no clue what he's saying, bro. All the other ones I can understand just fine. By the way, a very simple beat for this week. I've got a couple big ideas coming up. I'm trying to save time so I can work on those. Before playing the final beat, I want to say thank you for watching. Hopefully, if you're trying to make some beats in this style, this video helped you in some way. So yeah, this is what the final beat sounds like.